folks. This is all the fruit. And here I have the mummy, or mummy apple, or what was it also called? South American apricot, tropical apricot, Caribbean apricot, Dominican apricot. Well, where do all those names come from? Well, mummy maybe is quite easy to explain. It is, it's quite similar to a part of the female anatomy, which is quite important for mothers, especially for nursing mothers. Mummy apple, well, everything that's about middle size and roundish, and the Europeans meet in a different part of the world, they call it apple. But why so many names with apricot? I cut it open already. Well, the flesh inside is orange. Well, yeah, this is more like an apricot than an apple, but you could also name it, what, pumpkin or yellow plum or whatever. Why apricot? Well, let's look at it a little bit closer. So the outer skin is brown and not warty, but the opposite. It has a lot of indentations, a lot of convex little spots. It's quite thick, about 3 millimeters. The flesh is really tough, although this one is really ripe, so the flesh is, wow, this might be the softest mummy I've ever had in my life. I did pick the most ripe one of the whole bunch, and I also kept it in my backpack for like a day and a night. Well, here you can see near the penuncle, the skin is even thicker. The rind is even thicker, over half a centimeter. Most of the inside of the fruit has been taken up by the huge seeds. Well, the flesh will be tough even in the fully ripe state. Actually, first time I harvested a couple of those mummies, I carried them around for like over a week until they got a little bit softish, sweetish. It got some flavor, but then I threw them away because I thought that I picked them underripe and they would never get ripe. Well, little did I know that that's all I can expect from the mummy. Now let's try this really overripe and maybe, and pretty squished and maybe even slightly fermented part. It doesn't smell fermented. Yeah, it's quite soft for a mummy. It has more or less the texture of a half-cooked pumpkin. This one doesn't have too much of an apricot flavor. More like a peach flavor of a peach which has been picked underripe. But at least the fresh is much softer than anything I've gotten, either here in the Canaries or in the Caribbean or in Asia. Quite a soft mummy, this one, but not really tasty. Somebody explained me it's emotionally very important fruit for the Cuban immigrants here in the Canary Islands. Most people wouldn't think it's a very valuable fruit. I mean, it's tough. Most of the space is being taken up by the seeds and the rind. The taste is not so superior, especially not in a subtropical fruit paradise like the Canary Islands, where you can basically grow almost everything. And for months you can import much better tasting apricots from Spain. Remember, in the Caribbean, until recently, they didn't have good ways to import a temperate or subtropical apricots. They just had this tropical apricot. So basically, yeah. I mean, if you find it somewhere, buy one, try it, but don't expect too much. As I said, this was pretty much the softest mummy I've ever eaten, but also one of the least flavorful. Yeah, the flesh is finally turning soft, but no flavor. So, folks, this was the mummy, Mummy Americana, from the Americas, grown and eaten here on the island of Tenerife. Stay tuned for a lot more fruit videos from the parks, gardens, shops, markets, and supermarkets of Tenerife. And don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe.